Why do we need the UPS monitoring for? When devices operate on the battery power from an uninterruptible power supply, if the power outage occurs and it lasts for a long time, the battery may run out, and the UPS turns off with the connected devices. Because of this, the devices can be damaged or lose data. To prevent this from happening, you need to constantly monitor the performance of the UPS. This can be done in two ways: locally or over the network using SNMP. UPS parameters can be monitored locally via USB or COM interfaces, simply by connecting the UPS to a computer using a cable. You can monitor and customize settings through a special program from the device manufacturer. All the most basic parameters will be available for monitoring, such as the battery charge and voltage in the external and internal networks. This monitoring method has a number of disadvantages. It will not be possible to monitor remote UPS. Also, it will be possible to work with only one UPS at a time. This monitoring method is most suitable for home PCs. The most advanced monitoring method is to monitor remote UPS devices over the network using SNMP. This way, it will be possible to track more parameters, and most importantly, it will be possible to see information from several remote devices. There are two ways to monitor the UPS via SNMP: passive and active. 10-strike network monitor can do all this, and now we will show you how. In the first case, the program simply receives SNMP trap messages, which are sent by the UPS itself. The program will receive these messages and react to them in a certain way. To do this, start the program, go to the monitoring tab, and select the SNMP trap item. Next, click on the switch. You can also configure the program for certain messages to send notifications to the administrator via SMS or email, or execute a custom script. Done. The program is now receiving messages. When monitoring is active, the program itself polls the device at a specified interval, using the SNMP protocol, and receives the value of the necessary parameters. First, add your UPS to the host list. Then we add the SNMP check. Next, you need to specify the parameter that we will monitor. Each parameter corresponds to a special set of numbers. It is called OID. For convenience, OIDs are stored in a special MIB file, where they can be viewed in the tree form. Due to standardization, for most UPS models, the list of OIDs is the same. Otherwise, the required MIB file is usually available on the manufacturer's website. In this example, we will be monitoring the battery charge. Enter the desired OID, if you know it. If not, you can open the MIB file in a special browser and find it there. Next, we set the condition for the alarm to be triggered. For example, if the remaining battery power is less than 15%. In this case, the check will be considered failed. Next, you can configure what the program will have to do when the UPS battery is running out. For convenience, in the description of the check, we write the phrase battery charge. Enable the alert message option, so the alert window should appear on the screen when the failure occurs. In addition to alerts, you can also execute scripts. We indicate that the server should be forced to shut down in order not to lose data. You can also add a script, so that the switch, for example, should save a backup copy of its configuration to some media. This is so that you do not have to reconfigure it after turning on the power. Done. The check has been created. Click on the Monitored Parameter tab to see the chart. At the moment, the battery charge is 75%. If it drops below 15, the program will notify the user using the alert window and execute the script. You can display and observe the UPS parameters on the graphic network map using a variety of indicators. You can find the link to download the monitoring program is in the description for this video.